Hi, my name is Kristin Smith, and I'm here with Plugged In. So today we're going to be doing a breakdown of iOS 12's new parental control features. iOS 12 is the newest operating system for both iPhones and iPads. Let's get started.
Okay, so to start, we're going to go ahead and go into Family Share. So you're going to type in Family into your search bar, and it's going to pop up here into Family Sharing. Once you get into Family Share, you're going to add a family member. Now, there are three ways to do this. You can either invite via iMessage. So when you click this, it's going to send a message to your child that already has an Apple ID account, and they can set this up from afar. Or you can click Invite in Person. And when you do that, you can do it in person with your child. They'll have to enter their Apple ID and their password. And then the third option, as you click Add a Family Member, is to create a child account. Now, when you get into this, there are going to be a few steps. The first is you'll have to enter your child's birthday. Once you enter your child's birthday, once you get into privacy, parent privacy disclosures, you're going to agree to it, and then you're going to have to insert your three-digit code on the back of your card that is set up to your Apple ID. This is for parents just to indicate that they know that you are in fact setting this up for your kid. You're also going to need to create a four-digit passcode. We're not going to do this right now. This passcode is going to be specific to parents. Okay, once you add a family member, you're going to click Screen Time. Now, for my son, he's a year, he doesn't have anything. You're going to see here the activity that your child has been using. So normally it would record what your child's been using today, and then as well as in within the last 7 days. But again, nothing is recorded for my kid. Okay, one of the first features we're going to look at is downtime. Downtime is going to require you to put in that four-digit passcode. And once you put in the passcode, you're going to have a few options. First, you can either select downtime. And downtime is going to it's going to block all of the things on your child's phone. So you're going to choose a start time as well as an end time. So let's say I wanted to block my kid's phone from 10 a.m. to 9 p.m. Everything would be blocked. There are a few things that are not blocked during downtime, and that would be FaceTime, messaging, phone calls, but you can change that to block that as well, and we'll get to that later. The next one is app limits. So you're gonna add a limit, and so you have a few categories here: social networking, games, entertainment, and there are a few. So let's say I wanted to limit my son's usage of social networking. If we're in social networking and we want our child to have 2 hours a day of social networking time, you're allowed to do that. You can also customize the days. So if you want every day of the week for them to be able to use it for 2 hours, you can choose that. You can change it as well. Now, the frustrating thing with apps and categories, for social networking, normally you'd see like Facebook or Instagram or Snapchat here, but again, my son doesn't use any of these, but these would be it. You are not allowed to pre-select which category they go into. Now, the way to make sure that you know which category they'll fall under is when you're in the app store, it should have this logo here, and then you'll be able to see what apps fall under social networking. So let's say the app limit has expired. You can control this, and you can say you want to block at the end of their limit. So what this does is continue to block their social networking use, and the child will have to ask for more time. It'll send an update to your phone asking for an hour or 15 minutes, and you will have to approve that with your code. If you do not approve it, they cannot have more time. After app limits, and again, there are multiple categories, you can choose always allowed. Now, I don't have a lot of apps here. We've already talked about that, but normally there'd be a list of different apps here. And if I want my son to be able to always use these outside of the limits that I've already set, I would move them from this category up to here. And this is messages, FaceTime, then again, you can just move them and put them down here. The next is allowed apps. And so we've already went over this, but if there are apps that you always want allowed, you are able to just click them on or off. It's super simple. Okay, and then there's content restrictions. I think this is gonna be a winner for most parents. So we're gonna choose ratings for the United States. And then if you wanna go into music, podcast, news, you can choose clean or explicit. Music profile and post, whether it's posting or reading, you can choose on or off for your kids. Movies, you can choose the rating that you would like them to be able to watch. I chose G. TV shows, I chose Y, but again, you can have any that you would like. You're gonna have books. Books here can either be clean or explicit. And apps. So the age is a little deceiving, because if I chose 4 and up, who knows what would be included in that. So just be aware of that as a parent, that you can choose the age grouping, but you're not really sure exactly what falls under that. Okay, for web content, For your teen, kid, whatever it is, you can choose unrestricted access, limit adult websites, or only have allowed websites. Since my son is very young, I chose only allowed. Now, these are the only allowed websites that are included. You have Discovery Kids, Disney, all this stuff. But if there's something else that I want to add, I can just click add a website, like plugged in, and I can put it in here, and that would also be added to the list of allowed websites that my child is allowed to use. The next is with Siri, so web search content. You can either allow or not allow that. And then with explicit language, again, you can either allow or not allow. And finally, on the game center, whether you want to allow or not allow your child to play multiplayer games, to add friends, or to screen record, you can indicate that here. Okay, and then here we also have a few things. So for passcode changes, if you don't want your kid being able to change your passcode, just click don't allow. Account changes, again, you get to dictate that. Cellular data, do not disturb while driving. This is great for any parent that has a teen. You can just say, don't allow. TV provider, so they're not able to change that. And then any background app activities, they can also go allow or not allow. A few final things here is including website data. So again, there's nothing up here for screen time, but if I want to see what data my child is using, like as far as websites are concerned, all of that will be up here in screen time. But if you don't want to see that, you can just click it off just as simply. And the very last two things would be changing your screen time passcode, which is the 4-digit passcode. You are able to change that whenever you want as parents, and then turning off screen time altogether. So if you click this, all the data up here is not going to be reported. Any of the limits that you've set, those are going to go ahead and be removed and erased, and you'd have to reset them later in the future. So here, when it comes to turning off screen time as a parent, you're able to do this and then all of the data will be removed, but your child is not allowed to do this on their own. It would require the 4-digit passcode, and so they're not able to erase the data if you wanted to see it. Again, that's going to require a 4-digit passcode from a parent.
So to wrap everything up, we're going to go ahead and talk about passcode and time limits one more time. So let's say your child has reached their limit for their app settings or whatever you've restricted and they want more time. You're going to get a notification that says, can I have 15 more minutes? Can I have an hour? Or whatever that time allotment is. You're able to choose to give your child more time or to restrict it completely. And again, that's all done with your 4-digit passcode. And that wraps up our iOS 12 parental control review. And as always, be sure to subscribe to Plugged In on YouTube for more tech and entertainment reviews. For PluggedIn.com, I'm Kristin Smith.